the second half of our countdown begins in Cedar City, Utah, where 25-year-old Tristan Lamoureux awaits sentencing.
He was convicted of killing his 19-year-old wife.
You've got family members in the courtroom, and the feeling is incredibly tense.
The defendant was surrounded by at least four court officers,
so they're very well aware that there's a situation that may transpire.
The victim's brother, 28-year-old Jason Wilson, gets up to speak on the family's behalf.
The danger of these victim impact statements is multifold. First, because we're at sentencing, so we know the guy did it. Second, you bring people just too close together. They can see each other's eyes.
While Mr. Wilson is pouring his heart out, he glances over at the defendant. What's the defendant doing? He's just rocking in his chair like it's Sunday afternoon watching a football game.
The brother kind of jerks a step forward as if, I'm going to get you.
Mr. Wilson retreats briefly, and then it's on. He's going through bailiffs, whoever he has to get to the guy who killed his sister.
Officers were very quick and not only subduing the brother, but also restraining Mr. Lamoureux and getting him away from the scene.
Officers take the brother out of the courtroom and charge him with disorderly conduct. The defendant is later sentenced to 15 years to life in prison.
As a big brother, I'm sure he feels helpless and wishes that he could have done more to protect his sister.